Well, I have my cheapy Galaxy Nexus here, and the reason I call it cheapy is because I got it in this box of parts, and if you watch my, I can't remember what I called that video, but if you go back a couple of videos, I kind of explain where I got these parts, how much I paid for them, and whether they work, and all that kind of thing. So, obviously, this Nexus works, or I wouldn't spend any money to fix it, but the only issue I have, and I show this in the other video too, is the volume rocker. The actual physical button was missing. I think he must have lost it when he tore the phone apart, but anyway, I got the new front glass on it. It looks really good. I mean, the phone is just like brand new, other than that small little problem, and it works perfectly fine. And the best thing is it only stands me about $20, and most of that cost was just the new front glass. The only issue I had with the new front glass is that it's not quite as thick on the bottom. I don't know if you can see that in the video, but this original glass is pretty thick. It's quite thin at the top, and it tapers up to quite a thick spot on the bottom. And the new one wasn't like that. It was thicker on the bottom than the top, but not as dramatic as that one. But it still works, so I'm not going to worry about it. And I also have all of these parts here, and one of the parts phones that I showed in the last video was this Samsung Galaxy S2, and this is the HD LTE Bell version. And I've been looking for another parts phone because this motherboard is actually good. It works perfectly fine. And I wanted to kind of try to fix this one, and I couldn't find a reasonably priced parts phone anywhere until I found this one. And I got this on Kijiji. A girl locally, not too far away from me, had it, and she said she only bought it 4 months ago, which I'm not real sure about, since this is pretty much a two-year-old phone. Like, at least it was released 2 years ago, but it works pretty good. Actually works really good, except for the crack here, and there's a crack that runs up the side here, and another one, I think, that, yeah, one here that branches off. Yeah, you can see it a little better on the white screen, or at least I can. Other than that, the phone works great. The only problem is this particular model is kind of a pain in the ass because you can't find a reasonably priced place to unlock it. And plus, they don't sell a front glass for this one. So I'm trying to find one, but it's not working out too good. I've checked Google, I've checked eBay, checked all kinds of different sites, and they don't sell the front glass. They sell the whole screen assembly, but I don't want to buy that because that would cost probably three times as much as I paid for the phone. So anyway, I'll live with it the way it is, and this one here is going to be my daily phone. It might not be the top of the line for today's technology, but it's way better than any phone I've had so far, so I'm pretty happy with that. But anyway, I should stop yapping and get something done here. But before I do, I want to just mention a couple of other parts that I ended up listing on eBay. I can't find the iPhone 4 main board right at the moment, but I have an iPhone 4 main board and battery that came in this box of stuff, and then this 3GS. I haven't listed this on eBay yet, but I'm going to probably later on today. And the iPhone 4 main board and battery I've already listed. It's got 13 bids. I think it's up to $35. I paid 10 bucks for the whole box, so if I can get, even if I get $35, I'm pretty happy with that. That means that this phone is free. This phone would cost me probably about 20 bucks total if I can make $35 or $40 off of that iPhone 4 main board. So I'm going to list this 3GS main board and battery and see what happens with that. I'm pretty sure I won't get as much out of that as the iPhone 4 board, but we'll see what happens, and I'll do an update video later on to actually tell you exactly how much I get for the iPhone 4 board and also this one. I'll probably put this one up for 5 days rather than the 10 that I put the iPhone 4 board on for. So anyway, gonna go, and I'll talk to you guys later.